follow along if you want to find out how to set up Claude Desktop to control Isaac Sim through an MCP server. Ever since Anthropic introduced Model Context Protocol, they have been popping up everywhere, for good reasons. Here's how it works. You have an AI model like ChatGPT, Claude, or even open source models like Llama acting as MCP hosts. In the middle is the MCP client, typically a Python script that acts as a bridge. On the right, we have an MCP server which connects to all your tools and apps. Now let's look at this in action. Suppose you give a prompt like fetch the stock price of Apple and notify me via email. The AI agent first analyzes the intent, selects the right tools via the MCP client, and then the MCP server handles the actual API calls, fetching data from services, databases, or local files. The final result is routed back and delivered to the user. Here's a fascinating example built by Ahuja Sid, where Claude controls Blender using the MCP protocol. The user provides just a prompt and an image as a reference, and Claude orchestrates the entire scene creation inside Blender. Everything from object placement to lighting is done automatically through API calls. Most of the software we use these days can be controlled using MCP. Check out this demo by Mech Agent, where they use generative design to create CAD and SolidWorks. With IsaacSim 5.0 being completely open source last month, I figured this was the perfect time to explore an MCP-based way to control robots, to potentially leverage large language models to perform complex tasks. After some digging, I came across this repo by Eric and Zong, where they demonstrate controlling IsaacSim through an MCP server setup through Cursor. Impressive work. In this video, we'll be recreating that setup, but instead of using Cursor, we'll be using Claude Desktop as the AI agent. Head over to the GitHub link in the description. Make sure you already have NVIDIA Isaac Sim installed. Since Claude Desktop isn't officially available on Linux yet, follow this link to build an app image on your desktop. Also, make sure you have installed these packages globally in your system environment. Next, clone the IsaacSim MCP repository into your documents folder. Copy-paste the IsaacSim launch command into your terminal. I'm modifying the command slightly since I installed IsaacSim through IsaacLab. But if you've installed it separately, use the exact command from the repo. Once IsaacSim loads up, make sure the MCP extension is turned on. You should see a terminal message from IsaacSim that the server has started on localhost. Let's create a virtual environment now. I'll call it MCP_venv. Once you've sourced the environment, run these commands in your terminal. Now your server.py should confirm that it's connected to the IsaacSim server, and you'll also see a log in IsaacSim that the client is connected. Next, launch Claude Desktop app image you downloaded earlier. Go to File, Settings, Developer, then click Edit Config to open this file in a text editor. Copy-paste the MCP server snippet from the repo into this file and save it. Exit Claude through the app before running it again from terminal. Yikes, something's wrong. Let's check the file we just saved. Right. You'll need to update the username field in the config to match your system's actual username. Let's try launching Claude again. No errors. That's good. To confirm everything's working, click on Search and Tools button. You should see Isaac Sim listed here as an integration with all the available tools loaded from the MCP server. And with that, we have a working MCP connection between Claude and Isaac Sim. Do note, Claude can sometimes call wrong tool names or functions if instructions are not clear. But it's also good at reasoning and recovering from simple errors. Currently, the MCP tools don't include joint level robot control, so you won't be able to move the robot in Sim just yet. If you want to build your own tools, check out server.py inside Isaac MCP folder. I plan on adding tools for robotic manipulation soon, so keep an eye out for updates, and thanks for watching.